So, of course, a lot of us are going to be paying attention to the national and statewide races, but there are some hyper-local propositions and ballot issues, and some of them have some contention all their own.
It's a big pig controversy in Miller County.
They can't be good neighbors, and we don't want them at all.
Proposition 6 would ban large-scale swine operations, a.k.a. pig farms. Supporters say they're trying to keep out big corporations, but those against say it'll hurt local family-owned farms.
Proposition 6 seeks to balance property rights and keep these guys from ruining our water aquifer, killing our clean air, and destroying our property values.
We have private property rights in this country. There are already rules and regulations in place that protect us from things like water issues or odor.
Heading up north, it's a battle over whether to create what would be one of the state's newest cities in Weber County on roughly 100 square miles of land west and southwest of Plain City.
We want a seat at the table on how to manage that growth when it comes.
Proposition 18 would incorporate a yet unnamed city called West Weber Community. The opposition group Keep Weber Western says taxes will rise exponentially, but supporters say the county is already raising taxes and it's time for local control.
Where do we want commercial? Where do we want residential? Where do we want to preserve farming and agriculture, and how we want that community to look?
Also on ballots across the state, in Tooele County, a $170 million school bond and two propositions on rezoning land for development. In Davis County, an $8 million Bountiful Parks and Trails bond, $22 million bond to build a fiber network in Kaysville, and a $26 million bond in Syracuse for a new park and improvements to City Hall, Public Works, and Fire Station, and remodeling the police station. For Utah County, they'll consider an $80 million school bond and Prop 9, which would change the county's form of government. And both Summit and San Pete counties will consider a Recreation Arts and Parks, or RAP tax, each a tenth of a cent on certain goods.
Now, a lot of people will be paying attention to some school board elections. School boards have had to make some tough and controversial decisions this year because of COVID with those school schedules. We've got some re-elections up in Salt Lake County and Davis County as well, where we heard a lot of different voices from parents. So we'll have to see how those elections turn out. Live at the Capitol, Lauren Steinbrecher, Fox 13 News, Utah.